Hi, good day. How are you guys? My name is Nathan, a front-end developer from Melbourne. Haven't been recording for probably 2 months. Basically, I just paused recording and technical catching up for a few weeks and just need more time and on myself, thinking about life, spend time with the kids, and keep myself healthy. It's good to be back, and today I'm going to talk about React server-side rendering with the .NET Core. Alright, here's the demo, which is a boilerplate with the React server-side rendering and the .NET Core file implemented. Quite simple. If we look at the page, there's no starting, very simple, only HTML markups has been sent through the server. And just to demo what I mean by server-side rendering, if we look at the network of the first page loading, and here is the response. What has been sent through, actually it included all the markups. This is home, this is a SSR test. And all those content actually are rendered from home.js. This is obviously a React component. So which means server-side rendering is working. And this page comes with the SEO values, which means Google can fetch the content and find the relevance and index this site correspondingly. Yeah, which is good. So for React server-side rendering on .NET Core, we need the SPA services. I think you guys probably heard that 1 year or 2 years ago, it's mentioned that SPA service will be deprecated and it will not support .NET Core 5 anymore. But here is a solution. If you install the corresponding extension on version 5, that will solve the problem and it will be compatible with the .NET Core 5. Number two, Webpack. You need one client bundle, and basically you need a client entry from here, which is client.js, and you need a corresponding CSS loader, SAS loader, post CSS loader for auto prefix, and corresponding optimizations to minimize your bundle, and any plugins you need to. Right. Also, you need a server bundle, and the reason for that is you probably don't need to read CSS. Those can be ignored from the server side, and make sure the library target is CommonJS too, so it can be friendly for Node server. Even though I understand this is .NET Core, but .NET Core still utilizes Node services, yeah, which is inevitable. Right, the third thing I would like to mention is from the your backend. You need the view model. You can put it in whatever name, but this view model will be put into your index.js, which is the page host that React app, single page app, where you need to add the attribute ASP pre-render module, number one, and load the corresponding JavaScript, which is the main.server.js, which is defined in your Webpack. Then that's where you you load the view model. Aside from that, a tiny little thing might be ignored is you need to add all those tag helpers, those are which are provided by the library, and that's pretty much for the backend. Then move to the frontend. You need a client.js, which is a client entry. Also, you have to define that entry in your client Webpack client bundle, where you utilize hydrate from React DOM. Also, you need a server entry, which is server.js, from where you need to import create server renderer from ASP.NET pre-rendering. Basically, from my understanding, this is a trigger like a node server, and you are running that node server, and you render all those React markups by utilizing React server DOM render to string method, and then send the markups as well as the server data, which is server-side initialized data, which is a view model, which will be saved in the window object as window.serverData, and with those all, send them to the front end. That's how it works. But a common mistake for React server-side rendering is wherever you are using a window or any object only browser has, and that if that's been passed to the backend, that'll be an error. That's why you need an indicator to tell whether this is client or the server side. Well, fortunately, thanks to Webpack define plugin, we can define a variable just for client bundle and make it as true, so we know. So in our React component, we can tell whether this is client side or the server side, so as to bypass the possibility that server will hit window or any browser related objects. To sum up, you can understand the React server side rendering works as any other view engine works. Basically, it will render the markups to string and send it to the front end as HTTP response. For Razor view, it's a Razor markups. For React, they were React markups. Who does the job? Actually, is a render to string function from React server DOM. You still need to utilize node service. So if we are using a node server, that will be even more straightforward. And I would like to demo that in the next tutorial. Thanks for watching. And if you like this video and you find it helpful, please smash the like button and subscribe to my channel. And thanks for your support.